In this video, I'm going to talk about reliability and when reliability parameters should be used in practice.
Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description.
Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. When using a measurement tool in physiotherapeutic practice, one can have several goals. You may either want to discriminate someone who is sick from someone who is healthy, you may want to evaluate a certain treatment effect, or you might want to predict a future outcome, for example, the chance of chronicity. If my goal is to distinguish two patients from each other, for example, if I want to know which person is sick and which one is not, I will have to use a measurement tool with a high degree of reliability. Reliability always depends on the variability amongst the persons to be tested. One can imagine that it is easier to distinguish between patients who look very sick from persons who look pretty healthy just by looking at them. In this case, my reliability will be rather high. If I perform repeated measurements of the same person or a group of persons in time just by myself, we call this intra-rater reliability. If two or more persons evaluate a person or a group, we are talking about inter-rater reliability, so the reliability between people. Next to the variance of study objects, reliability is always dependent on the measurement error, which you can imagine is huge when I'm just using my judgment of a patient's outer appearance. If I have to distinguish two persons who do not look very sick or very healthy, my measurement error would be too big to distinguish them. So in this case, my reliability would be low. If, however, I was able to use a blood test, for example, my measurement error would be very small and I could discriminate the persons with high precision. This influence of variability and measurement error on reliability becomes clear when we look at the basic formula of how reliability is calculated. Reliability is the variability of study objects divided through the variability of study objects plus the measurement error. So if the measurement error is small in comparison with the variability between the study objects, the reliability will approach 1, which is a perfect reliability. On the other hand, if the measurement error is rather big compared to the variability between the study objects, the reliability will approach 0, which stands for no reliability. A very important aspect affecting reliability and reproducibility in general is standardization. A measurement protocol and training can make sure that all measurements are taken in the same way by one or different assessors in order to cancel out variations in the use of the measurement instrument or in environmental factors that might influence the measurement outcome. In other words, the measurement error will be minimized. So, reliability parameters assess whether study objects, often persons, can be distinguished from each other despite measurement errors. When you are reading a paper about reliability, you should therefore always be aware of the group that was tested in the study. If the cohort was very homogeneous, so for example only healthy people, reliability values will be much lower because it's harder to distinguish them from each other. If the cohort is really heterogeneous, so for example really sick and really healthy people, reliability values will be much higher than in real life practice. There are several ways to express reliability. The easiest is the percentage of absolute agreement between repeated measurements of one person or several persons. A very common measurement that is used for binary values, so for example yes, no, is the kappa value k. If more than two values are available as an outcome, then a weighted kappa is used. If you want to learn more about the kappa value, click on the link in the top right corner. Value labels for corresponding ranges of kappa statistics are often used as assigned by Landis and Koch, which you can see in the table right next to me. Another very common measurement that is used for continuous measurements is the so-called intra-class correlation coefficient, abbreviated as ICC. ICC values are used in case the clinical outcome is measured on a continuous scale, so for example, the agreement on range of motion in the shoulder. Acceptable ICC values in diagnostic studies for the inter-rater reliability are usually defined above 0.75 and 0.9 for the intra-rater reliability. To sum it up, reliability is defined as the degree to which study objects can be distinguished from each other despite measurement errors. If you want to evaluate if your patient has improved after your treatment, you have to use agreement parameters. Click on the video right next to me to learn how this is different from reliability. All right, this was our video on reliability. We hope this clarified a lot of things. If it did, please give this video a like, subscribe to our channel, and turn on the notifications in order not to miss any new videos. If you still have any questions, just drop a comment down below. This was Kai for Physiotutors. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.